first reading, a reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We instruct you, brothers and sisters, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, to shun any brother who walks in a disorderly way and not according to the tradition they received from us. For you know how one must imitate us, for we did not act in a disorderly way among you, nor did we eat food received free from anyone. On the contrary, toil and drudgery, night and day we worked, so as not to burden any of you. Not that we do not have the right, rather we wanted to present ourselves as a model for you, so that you might imitate us. In fact, when we were with you, we instructed you that if anyone was unwilling to work, neither should that one eat. May the Lord of peace himself give you peace at all times and in every way. The Lord be with you, all of you. This greeting is in my own hand, Paul's. This is the sign in every letter. This is how I write. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with all of you. The word of the Lord. The responsorial psalm, blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Blessed are you who fear the Lord, who walk in his ways. For you shall eat the fruit of your handiwork. Blessed shall you be and favored. Blessed are those who fear the Lord. Behold, this is the man blessed who fears the Lord. The Lord bless you from Zion, and you may see the prosperity of Jerusalem all the days of your life.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Whoever keeps the word of Christ, the love of God is truly perfected in him. Hallelujah.
Everybody out, and so he shows on like this big screen outdoors on this mouse and this toaster, you know? And it's just absolutely embarrassing for the owners, because they're showing it to every all the customers as well. And then Gordon Ramsay says, okay, you know, for all the customers, I will pay your bill for all this food. Come back in 24 hours, and I'm going to transform this place. And you come back, and you tell me, you know, how the food is. And so that's his time to spend time cleaning the place. He starts right away with laying into the whole staff. And it's like what Jesus is doing here. He's laying into, in a sense, the staff of God. He's laying into them and then accusing them, like, how did this all get wrong? You know, you appear so righteous on the outside, but, you know, on the inside, you know, as I'm, like, looking into your very lives, you know, it's like that moldy chicken, it's like that dead rat, and it stinks, and it makes me want to puke, even. I think that's one thing that we have to keep in mind whenever we want to live a life of conversion, really want to live a life of the Lord. We have to be willing to let the Lord actually call us out, and actually say, look, there's something wrong in here. You may think that you're doing good things, sometimes we have to let ourselves be accused, let ourselves be hurt by that. What's interesting about the show is that when Gordon Ramsay just lays into the cooking staff there, and then there's always a defense mechanism, there's always like a reaction, like, no, no. But he just keeps laying it into them. And then eventually, and this is the sentimental part of the show, this is when Gordon Ramsay sits down one-on-one with either the owner or the chef or whoever's really kind of the problematic person, and then he says, what's really going on? And that's when they start opening up that you know, there's maybe like that person went through a divorce or some problematic, traumatic thing happened in their childhood, whatever it is, and then that's when that healing starts to happen in the show. That when the owner of the restaurant is lashing out at the staff, it's indicative that they're being lashed out internally. And so then the Lord brings that to light. And so after we receive that accusation, we should be willing to be healed and to ask for that healing. And then here's really what makes the show, it's not my favorite part, but what's the best part of the show, is that at the end of 24 hours, when we open back up the restaurant, and then they're transformed through like this boot camp with Gordon Ramsay, and they're called. Everybody that has been called out from the beginning is now called to serve, and to serve now their new patrons, and to serve them with a new meal after receiving training from Gordon Ramsay, responding to show hospitality, and you just see the transformation of everyone who has been called out. They're now more joyful. They're joyful because they're willing to give, they're willing to serve, they're willing to make this new gift of themselves. And so that's what we're called to, is that whenever we want that conversion in our life, we should be called to serve one another, and to serve that person who may be problematic in our life, whether that person is the nagging spouse, or the kids, or, you know, a friend that your relationship has gone broken apart. When we are transformed by the Lord Jesus, we're called not to kind of hold back and just say, yeah, I've been transformed. But your transformation serves a purpose. It serves towards actually reconciliation, forgiveness, serving your family anew. At this Eucharist, may the Lord continue to convert our hearts. May he accuse us of all of our wrongdoing. May he heal us and transform us and train us with his own angels and saints. May he call us to give of ourselves once again as he gives himself on this altar over and over and over again for us.
Mystery of faith. Save us.
Save the world. Remind the cross and resurrection. Give us that spirit.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, and offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, we make thanks and call us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and pray.
Christ, who